It promises to heat and cool 37 buildings and around 140 customers by tapping into geothermal energy. This morning, Congressman Jake Auchincloss and Democratic Whip Katherine Clark were out in Framingham getting a look at Eversource's geothermal pilot project, which is scheduled to be up and running by the end of this year.
It is going to be great for consumers and bring down the cost of electricity.
Just demonstrates that a transition to a clean energy future goes hand in hand with good jobs and lower costs.
We first told you about this groundbreaking project more than a year ago. It requires drilling nearly 90 holes, 600 to 700 feet in the ground, networking those 140 customers here in Framingham into a loop.
We find that, you know, in these urban areas, we feel like it's going to have a great success rate because there are a lot of building connections you can make in a short distance.
Nikki Bruno is Eversource's Vice President of Clean Technologies. The project, which is forecasted to cost $14 million, could end up saving those buildings in the loop between 25 to 75% of the energy required for their heating and cooling needs and potentially lowering emissions by 60%. While work is being done to complete this pilot project, thanks to some grant funding, Eversource is already looking to add more homes here in Framingham to their geothermal loop.
We're evaluating the feasibility and kind of early design of what an expansion of the existing loop would look like. Think of it like a Lego set. You know, you build blocks over in one section and keep adding blocks on. So it's really a community forward way to look at decarbonization.
Now, it is easier to expand a loop than to start a new one, but when Representative Auchincloss was leaving here, he did tell Eversource officials he would like to see this type of infrastructure in his district. Reporting live in Framingham, Matt Reed, WCVB News Center 5.